First, we're gonna be working on getting the some silage in the biogas here. Whoops, running into the bucket. Then we gotta go work on crops. Looks like we're getting a little glitch with the vehicles again. There's something with this map that we've been having trouble with the vehicles getting stuck at, like, going real slow and kind of jittery like that. And one of the things that we think is contributing to that a little bit is possibly the silage, but Jason had said that because we hadn't touched the silage since the server reset or restarted the server, that it was working pretty good. But I see there's a little that's probably the stuff I just dumped in. We'll just have to work with it here. That's been probably the only big problem we've had so far with the map. Some of our vehicles not going right. I got her to the floor right now, and this is all we're getting. Let's see what the ping is. Up there a little bit. About 40, 45. It's not too bad. What is going on? Got Jason and Lee sitting in the old hot seat here. Kansas Farmer, Matt, One Donnie, thank you. Whoops, thank you everybody for joining. Oh, don't dump it. Really hard to work with this right now. Very, very unresponsive. Yeah, this isn't looking too good, is it? I want to get some silage. We got to hammer through all this. Money-wise, I'm not sure where they're sitting at. I guess it's kind of irrelevant since money is hard to come by. Pretty much the equipment that's in here right now has been quite a grind to get. Oh, crapper. I think it's so hard to operate right now. I think we'll let that set like that. All right. Oh, look at that. Somebody left the hood up. I don't know why that's up. Somebody must have been changing the oil in it. Apparently I tabbed past it here. Oh, that was the one. That was the one we needed. I'm gonna be going up and taking corn off the field. Lloydinator, how's it going? Go back to work. Yes, get back to work, Lloyd. Thanks for stopping by for a second. No stream tonight? No, it's a stream right now. We don't normally stream at all on Fridays, but we started doing this last week. I'm pretty sure next Friday I will not be doing an update. But I think most Fridays we will be. We'll be taking a few that we don't do. For sure. So, all right, let's go ahead and hammer this field out. There's something here with a little bit of an overlap. Gotta make sure we leave a little bit of a hang over here. We'll be doing about 2 hours on Pleasant Valley, and then we'll be heading over to good old Westbridge. Westbridge, there is a bunch of synchronized farming, going on over there. A bunch of it that's gotta happen. We've got crops that are almost about to wither. They were ready to go yesterday, and I thought, well, hopefully they'll last till tomorrow and they won't wither, but I mean, there's just like tons of fields ready to be harvested, and they're all about to wither. They're all dark green, and so I actually just went in, something we don't normally do, and I turned the withering off. Or had Lee do it. Lee went in, turned off the withering right before. Uh-oh, we're getting messages. Oh my goodness. Oh, chat on the screen? Yeah, well, we can leave the chat on the screen. Thank you for letting me know that, Lee. We'll leave the chat on the screen, I think. Last week we had it off, and a lot of people were asking, hey, why is it off? So, I think when we get more people in here, if we're doing a big multiplayer and stuff like that, it gets distracting because I'm carrying on conversation with players and stuff like that. And so sometimes we'll just keep that chat off. But today there's not very many people around. So, and Westbridge, I think Jason and Lee are going to join me over there because we've got some big fields to knock out. So, at least my harvester's going nice and smooth now. I was worried that it was going to be parting up a little bit like the front loader, but we're doing good. Let's see, what do I want to do here? Let's do some squares. But nobody's in here today, so we'll be having conversation with all of you. And DJ, how's it going? Stealth mode is activated. Oh my goodness. Yeah, we had open server day yesterday. Open server day. And this map, this server was open to everybody. We're going to be doing a subscriber only next week. Let's see. I was thinking next Friday, and Jason was saying let's do 2 days for the subscriber. So if you're a subscriber on the Twitch, this isn't set in stone yet, but I think it'll be Thursday evening about 6 o'clock my time, which is in a few hours. It's nearly 2 p.m. here, so it'll be about 6 o'clock in the evening-ish, somewhere's in there. I'll let everybody know on an email. If you're a subscriber, I'll be sending an email to say, hey, this our Pleasant Valley server's open for you if you play farming. Not all of our subscribers play farming, so it's just something extra I'd like to give back to subscribers. Also, because next week I'm not going to be doing any live streams, so we're going to be taking a little break, a little spring break, we're going to call it. I know next Wednesday there won't be a stream. I'm not going anywhere in particular. I'm just going to literally take a week from business and focus on some YouTube videos. I got to get a hunting video done next week that I've got planned that I've been doing a little bit of work on, and as well as getting, of course, chore log number 4 will be out, towards the end of next week. So, but yeah, anyway, Thursday evening through Saturday evening, probably close it up right before the live stream, Saturday's live stream. I'll kick y'all out of the server, so you gotta come watch the stream. But I think that's gonna be Thursday night, Friday, and most of the day Saturday. It'll be open to subscribers. That's not set in stone, but I'm pretty sure that's what we'll end up doing. So you'll get an email next Thursday letting you know, hey, here's the password. Come on into the TeamSpeak, and you'll have to get with an admin. You'll have to come on in and let us know, and we'll get you the links that you need, the mod pack and stuff like that. So all kinds of fun. We had a resub right before the stream, so whoever that was, thank you again for your continued support. And Kokobo the best, thank you so much for the follow. Appreciate that very much. I think we've got to be getting nearly full here. Go get a little truck here, and they've got the vehicle group deal in here, which is pretty nice. I was interested to try this out because I tried it out back in, it must have been Farming 13, because Farming 2011, I'm pretty sure I didn't use it in there, but I used it, it's just been a few years ago, and I didn't like the version then, or I didn't feel like I needed it or something. I mean, anyway, I didn't run it, I didn't use it very long, maybe a couple days, but I know with our Westbridge, we were talking about it, and I thought, man, that would be really nice, and I think this is something that I'm going to want to probably put into our other two servers. You hit the control key, and you can group, and I guess over here, it seems like something that we definitely could use, because right now we've got 1, 2, and 3. We've got tractors, combines, trucks. Eventually, what that'll be is white farm, blue farm, purple farm, but right now there's such little vehicles. I mean, you can see what there is, and there's not enough vehicles on each farm. Some farms have zero vehicles, or maybe they just have a truck or something. Maybe there's more vehicles than that. There's gotta, yeah, because there's a lot of pickups. So maybe they just haven't added all the stuff. But anyway, that's all the tractors, the combines, and they're up to three of these harvesters now. So it's better than a week or so ago when we're running around with the little shampoos, as I call them, or the shamoos, or shampoo. But anyway, we are 75%. See, it's nice, I can just tell by looking at the bin. Actually, I cheated. I looked at the, little inspector mod on the side there. That is one thing I do actually like about the inspector mod. It is a very small thing on the side of the screen there, instead of having my whole HUD open to see. You know, I kind of miss the New Holland, having it right in the cab. But, yeah, anyways. Moobot! Uh-oh, we got somebody that's salty. Is there a way I can scribe on my phone? Oh, that's a good question. And yes, Jason just typed the information. I guess that's the link. There. Oh, what farm is this? This is our Pleasant Valley. Pleasant Valley server. GunninGamerz, Pleasant Valley server. Again, none of our servers are open to the public. This is the server that is most open, though. We basically allow anybody in that's been, you know, in our community, and we know them a little bit, know that they're not going to do the wrong things. And we've got a list of people, and people have asked, how can I get in on that? Well, come hang out in our community. Let us get to know you. You know, yesterday we had an open server, open to anybody, and I'm happy to report it was open for a full 24 hours, and everybody that came in just did good stuff, and everybody was, you know, there was a good chunk of people that jumped in to play, and nobody farted anything up or planted grass. And I mean, even if they would have, well, we were planning on resetting, or we had made a save before we started it, and we were going to put that save in afterwards. And everybody did the right thing. I mean, everything went so well that there was no reason to do that. So everything that was done by people yesterday is progress that was saved. So we figured at least we'd come in and find a couple fields grassed in. But none of that happened. So that's great. But just due to the fact that it was taking us way too much, way too much resources, way too much effort and hours to keep our public server going, we had to close it up. And whoa, Nilly! All right, we will put our pipe out here. That's not the right one. How about that one? Oh my goodness. This is the problem that we have with this map. Don't know why it is, but vehicles don't like to go very nice. a lot of times. And we've kind of been through and pulled out all of the mods and only used the recommended mods that they recommend, and we still get the problem. Ooh. Makes me wonder if, like... Yeah, it doesn't seem to change anything. It's just gonna be boogery today. Just something with the map. Some glitch or bug or something. We've, like I said, we've pulled all of the stuff out of the map that... We've only put a couple of things, like the Chevy truck. And there may only be one or two other things, mods that we put in that weren't on their recommended mods list.
Buddy joined your channel.
Hey, Brian.
Hello.
Hey, I think I got a little solution for you on that man truck.
What's that?
If you go up to the Purple Farm with the New Holland tractor there.
Uh-huh.
There is a little, kind of like a dolly almost.
Uh-huh.
You can hook the trailer onto that and pull it with the tractor if you want to.
You think the tractor's gonna work better?
Tractor always works better. Well, most of the time.
Okay. What do you think it is? A problem with the actual truck? Or a problem with the map that's doing it?
I think there's something with the map. Not sure.
Because some of our vehicles that have no problems on other servers, they have the problem in here. I'll even look at the vanilla... Look at the vanilla front loader.
Yeah, that only goes up to 11 normally.
Yeah, it's acting up too, though, today. Before I even touch the silage. So, I don't know. We got her over here for now. So, I'll have to consider that. Appreciate that.
No problem. Just thought I'd give you a little heads up on that.
Yeah, I might...
I just bought that a few days ago.
Alright. I might do that. Thank you, sir.
Buddy left your channel.
Unload this. And off we go. Off we go again. Yeah, this is a blue farm. I can show the map here as well. I gotta get the, right up here. This is where we are working right now. So, four times map. So if you divide the map up into four chunks, that would be like Bjornholm in one corner. You know, something else, something, you know, it's like four Bjornholms or four Westbridge. It's a huge map. Very, very large map. No, it's not lag. It's not lag at all. We're actually very smooth as far as that goes. It's a problem that we've been having with the map, with the vehicles. We know silage causes it, and I do have silage going right now, so it may be that silage that's a culprit. But the harvester's working very nicely. Right now, I guess that's the most important thing. Well, of course, the harvester doesn't go very fast. I think if we were to chop the header off on it and take off, it would probably start doing the same thing. It's like you kind of get stuck at that 11, 10, 20 something mile an hour. Nothing likes to go over that. 4D, what's happening? I look tired? Oh, I woke up a few hours ago. Maybe the caffeine isn't kicking in. I was up till about 4 o'clock. 4:30 in the morning, which is kind of early. I've been setting my sleep schedule back quite a bit. Look at that wall. That thing is massive. I was in the Minecraft working on some projects in there. Holy crapper. I'm going to start the barn build tonight. It's going to be a real doozy. It is going to be a real doozy, let me tell you. I've been thinking it's gonna take over 1,000 blocks of red clay to build this barn that I want to build. It's gonna be pretty cool though if I get it done. I've never built anything that big, because I haven't built that many buildings in there. But we got our community building all finished yesterday. We started that a few weeks ago, but it was kind of like this big, empty, hollow sort of building, and we finished it off yesterday, and it's quite awesome. It is very, very user-friendly. It's got everything that we need, so, yeah, but we can always chat about the Minecrafts another time. Aiden was in there, having a good time. How much does this game cost? It's $29.99. Plus the DLC, which we do run the DLC. And that's one thing that might have kept a few people out of the server yesterday, is that we do run the DLCs. We will be running all of the DLCs. Because we like to support a game that we love so much, and at the end of the day, the game was a little bit cheap if you ask me. I mean, the amount of hours a person will get out of it for $29.99 is ridiculous. It's one of the best values in any game I think I play. I'll get 1,000 hours out of it in 2 years, and I'll pay $30 for it. It's crazy. And the DLC pack, you know, the IT trailer pack was $10, so I bought that. I've said in the past, you know, if they come out with, I always use a, you know, example, you know, if they come out with the vintage hay wagon pack, probably won't. I might buy it so that I can check it out and stuff, but we won't put that into our servers. That's not going to offer any value to a large farm. And all of our farms, we want them to be large scale. So, you know, and they've done things like that in the past, not necessarily just a hay wagon pack, but they've done some vintage stuff, and we would definitely be running that in like the Bjarnholm, like the vintage tractors. Oh man, I'd be getting them in a heartbeat. You know, if they come out with just small scale farming stuff, something like that, we would not put into Pleasant Valley because it wouldn't offer us a value. Gotten crooked there. It offer us no value as far as you know, getting the stuff done on the large farm like this. But yeah, they come out with tractor packs, and I've heard through the rumor mill, and I forget the brand name, maybe somebody can throw it up in there. Let's go to the store. That there's a company, their stuff is not in the game. Whoops, it's not that. Where do you find it? Oh, beet harvesting and potato harvesting. It's not this company. It's another company. They're European-based, maybe Germany, Deutschland. But they make large, very, very large potato sugar beet harvesting equipment. Like, it'll make this stuff look small. And it's in the rumors that I've heard that is going to be, like, the next DLC pack that we're going to get is that company. I don't know. We'll just call it XYZ Company because I forget the name. But XYZ Company makes large potato and sugar beet harvesting equipment. And there's going to be an XYZ Company pack. And so if that happens, absolutely we'll be adding that to all three of our servers. So, you know, if you ever want to play in our servers, you'll need to get all the DLCs, which right now there's only one for $10. So basically $39.99 when we do open server, you'll be able to get in. Homer, I think that's it. Homer? XYZ, yeah. That's a good name for a company, you know. It's very very short and sweet, easy to remember. Could have called it the Acme Farm Company or something. But, yeah, it's good stuff. Wow, am I all crooked on my fields here? We're all dinkered up. We'll make it around the mountain one more time here, and then we'll unload into our deal. all this will probably be used for something, maybe seed or fuel, or you gotta make all your own seed, your own fuel, all that on this map. Build factories, I mean, there's so much stuff that has to be done, it's so in-depth. Since update 1, which was last week, that was, I think the server was up for about 2 weeks at that point. See if the harvesters fart up at all. Nope. Not sure. Speed, we're going 13, so... What is the name of the server? It is GunninGamerz Pleasant Valley. But it is not open, open up to the public. It's our, one of our free private servers. And we, again, do open this one to the public. Like I said, the next one will be for all of the subscribers on the, Twitch here. We're gonna do, I think, 2 days, the end of next week. And then it'll probably be the week after that, so 2 weeks from now, when we'll do another open to the public. Probably go to the end of the row here. There she bees. Yeah, this thing goes faster than the truck does right now. It's almost like it's something with the fill triggers or the empty triggers or something like that. Whenever you... Well, then again, I undid the trailer and the truck still took off. I don't know what it is. It's something that just makes certain vehicles very slow. That we've had problems with on this map. A download for the map? It's Pleasant Valley Farm or something like that on Facebook. You can go to the video on the... Go to my YouTube. Go to the YouTube and go to... the update, which is probably one of the last videos I put up a week ago. For Pleasant Valley. Pleasant Valley Update 1. And there is a link in that description. So head over to the YouTube channel and look there. You will find it. You will find it. Slim Jims. Really freaking hot. Have, oh my goodness. I've never had those. Hey Sim, sneaks in for the early live stream. What is going on in here? Driving around, getting corn. Yep, we're just hammering out this field. I'm probably going to regret this, but I think I'm going to go over and stuff some more silage in the old hopper. See, it's still chewing it up. See, that might be why the vehicles are farting up a little bit. Might be. This vehicle here is not acting right either. They're going 5 or 6 top speed. It's half of what it should be, and it's not smooth at all. This is a vanilla vehicle, so this can't say it's something to do with the modded vehicle. It's nothing modded about this. Nice to have a name brand too over that lizard. God, this thing is terrible to work with right now. We are thinking about moving this server too to a different city just to get a little bit better maybe performance. That might actually be happening tonight, even. pull into here. Probably take one or two more. Oh, you know what? That stuff that was in the bottom, that probably is from when I got in the vehicle, it emptied out, because it doesn't empty out like it did in 13 when you just set it there. It won't empty out. You actually have to be in the vehicle now. Kind of weird. Grab one more. Please, your Bjornholm? Bjornholm, yeah, we do Bjornholm on Wednesdays and Sunday night. Load up here. So we see Bjornholm for about 6 hours a week. I do Bjornholm. Plus, it's also featured in our chore log, so this is the one day that we, are kind of designating. Again, there won't be an update next Friday, which will be nice because then the servers will really make some progress, especially this one. This one here will make some progress, and then we'll be able to, report back in about 2 weeks and see where we're at. Maybe we'll, who knows, might have some factories built, things like that. So yeah, you notice the Chevrolet is back in here. That's always nice. I don't know, this one here is having some engine issues, I guess. Getting worked on. Never really have checked out under the hood of this. Holy cow. Look at that. Look at that, that's a Nissan right there. Not a Nissan, it's a Nissan. Good stuff. See if this thing is still acting up. Yeah, it is. 3 miles an hour. Oh, we hit six. Oh, we're hitting two. We're three, four. Holy cow. This one might be staying out in the field. All right. Let's burn down the field here. Yeah, we'll be definitely seeing plenty of Bjornholm. Chore log will be out in about a week. About this time next weekend. Something of that sort. Oh, don't drink soda with it, drink milk. Oh, with the hot Slim Jim. No money? I'm not logged in as an admin. I don't really have a reason to log in as admin, so yeah, we don't see the money. We just see a big old zero, big old fat goose egg. But maybe Jason knows off the top of his head how much money's in here. Wasn't much. Money's hard to come by. This server's a real grind right now. Where can you get the mod? You can get it in our mod pack. Like, yesterday you could have gotten it, so the next time our mod pack will be open for all is, in about 2 weeks. 2 weeks from this week, we'll probably do another open server day. Probably gonna run them every other week. Something like that, so. Yesterday it was open for all, you just gotta come into our TeamSpeak and download it. We can't, it's in a mod pack right now, so we can't necessarily, just hand out everybody the mod pack because, there's nothing in there, well there are things in there we don't have permissions for, but a lot of these people, they do make, I think some of them make money off of people actually visiting the sites because of the advertisements and stuff like that, and we don't want to take that away from them. We don't want to say here's the link for our Dropbox or our Google download, and you can get it from here. When when basically you know, we're kind of taking some money away from those people, and I certainly don't want to be doing that. So we try to use the original links, but anyway, the Chevrolet is part of a mod pack, and we don't have a single link for it. We're not gonna do single links for all these things. Christ, our Dropbox and Google Drives are already full of stuff. But you can download the whole mod pack that we've got in our TeamSpeak, but that'll be on open server days. And if you want to find out when those are, you need to join on the Steam community, which is right underneath this what you're looking at. Scroll down on the page and look at the Steam button. Click that and join the Steam community. So once you see that we have an open server day, come into our TeamSpeak. There's a link for that. Click on that. That'll help you get downloaded the TeamSpeak and then get the IP punched in along with the password, which is Twitch, and jump into the TeamSpeak. And you'll be able to get the Chevrolet. And it's a nice little truck. We do have permissions on the Chevrolet. The gentleman that made that said, go ahead, have at it, do whatever you want to do to it. The original is nothing like that. It's much, much smaller. Does have the same sound, but it it's got white wall tires and it sits real low to the ground. And it has like a, we call it a fence that's on the back, which I think looks okay, but Jason pulled that off. They put bigger tires on it. They made it go faster. They gave it a little bit of a lift and pulled the thing off the back of the box and then they scaled it up to be the right size, because it was a little bit on the small size compared to some of the other stuff. And so a lot of things have been changed with it, and it's a really nice little pickup. But the original can be had. You can get that. Just look up Farming Sim 15 C10 pickup. Put that into Google and you'll find the original, and you can download that right now. That's all over on different websites. That's the same truck that we took and made some changes to over here. Hello, Buddy Bear Bruno from the Ukraine. What is happening? Do we change the? Yeah, we change the password, because like I said, this isn't an open public server all the time, but we're going to be opening it at certain times. This is a map that a lot of stuff can go very wrong. A lot, not only with some of the things you got to work around, because this map is so demanding with performance and things like that, but you know, it's a very, very in-depth map. You don't get seeds, you don't get fuel, you don't get fertilizer. You got to build factories to be able to do things. You got to get materials for building the factories. There's a mine, there's a quarry. I mean, there's so many different things going on in this map. It's not a good map to open up to just any old body, because somebody could come in here and they have all 100 ways of trolling the server, like regular vanilla farming, plus another 100 ways they could really screw you over. And it's not even just the trolling, it's that people might accidentally do something that they're not thinking is a big deal, and they might end up making a big deal by doing the wrong thing. I don't even come in here that much myself, not because I don't want to, but I just, you know, the time, it's hard to come in. So I'm trying to get in here more, especially Two Rivers. When it was a public server, I was never in there. I'm trying to get in here more, but I come in here and even I ask all the time, what should I be doing? Because I don't want to screw anything up. Because the regular people that are in here playing, they have a kind of a set thing that they're doing. And I mean, you know, it's a server with the GunninGamerz name on it, like I said, and I still come in here and I ask questions, because I need to know, like, what should I be doing? What do you want me to do? Where are we at? We have a Steam forum on the Steam there that a lot of the players use for communicating. It's another reason why our Steam is so important, the GunninGamerz Steam community. And it's a lot of communication that has to go on, and so we can't just open it up to the world, because it wouldn't work. It wouldn't work. Let's see if we can grab this whole thing. I don't think we're gonna... We'll go a little third person here. Our GunninGamerz community on Steam, VW Love, on Steam there. Again, if you click the Steam button below here, it'll bring you right to our page. And that's where we pretty much have the announcements of when the server will be open to the public. It's the best way to keep in a communication with us, our community. And it's also, you know, the whole reason I set the thing up is so that people could have a meeting place besides our TeamSpeak. But, you know, if there's a certain game that you're big time into, you know, like you love doing the hunting, go and put a post in there and say, hey, I love playing the hunter. I want to do some multiplayer hunts. People ask me all the time, hey, I want to come in and hunt. I really want to play. I don't even have time to play, you know, with half of my regular friends and stuff like that. I mean, Shoddy and Decoy stop by quite often, and they're, hey, you want to hunt? Oh, sorry, I don't have time. I don't even get to hunt with them. I, you know, just don't have the time. And so, and I may not always be in the same mood to play whatever, you know, everyone else, and I get hundreds of requests about playing different games, and I know how it is. It's more fun to have some multiplayer time, so that's why we got the Steam community, so you can jump over there, let people know what you're into, what you're wanting to do, and get in there and do it. Now tonight, I should spam this throughout. The 3 weeks ago on Friday, we started this little thing with the crew. We're in playing the crew, and it was a flippin' blast. 2 weeks ago, still had a blast in there, but not as many people showed up. And then last Friday, ended up not running it because I was doing this live stream, and there were some other things that were going on. And people seemed like they're busy, and I think I ended up doing some Minecraft or something, but I would really, really like to run the crew tonight, especially since we didn't last Friday. So if you have the crew, I'm thinking we'll probably jump in. I'll probably throw an announcement up to see if I can get everybody together. If you have the crew, get in there. Jump into our TeamSpeak. You know, the room that we go into is an adult area. It's adult room. You know, we got to keep things appropriate. a couple of us like to tip back a nice cold beverage and you know, have some adult fun. And men, women, whatever, we get in there. It's good fun. You know, get in there. And even if you're maybe not an adult, you can still get in there. You'll still find us in there, for crying out loud. I am GunninGamerz. It's the only game I call myself GunninGamerz, because my other stuff that I like to use was not available. It was not available. I was like, seriously? So I typed in GunninGamerz, like, and boom, it let me have that. So in the crew, I am actually GunninGamerz. But, you know, map is still there, and, you know, get a group of youngsters that maybe want to have their own little thing. We've got all kinds of channels for the younger crowd. They can pop into a room and try to get a big group together to do some racing. The biggest problem, though, I found with that game is sometimes it's hard for some people to almost be in the same server. You know? Because sometimes, like, I don't see you. Well, I'm sitting here in Detroit in front of the headquarter, like, right next to the trash can on the sidewalk, and I don't see you. You know? It's just that's the way it is, so. Alright, well, we popped that one out. Whoops. I think it was 61. So where are we here? We're up here. 61 is down there. I'm not sure if there's equipment down there or not. That one was about to pop. Yeah, it's still not yet. So it's in the dark blue, but it probably won't make it today, and that's okay. We'll go ahead and put this back. Yeah, playing games for a living and no time to play. It's ridiculous how, I mean, there's just so many games and, you know, and that's the damn truth about it. My wife will tell you too. Now, this job, I'm not going to lie, it's not as stressful. When I was working at the bank back in 2000, well, I worked there in 06 and all that when things were starting to get bad, but in 2008, it was so stressful when our economy was going to hell, and I was watching people losing everything, and it was depressing, it was stressful, I got yelled at by people every day, I got people that would call me crying, I got people that were, you know, desperate, I had just, it was like as if there was something as a loan officer that I could do to make their problems go away, and I couldn't, and some of the things that we had done as a bank, and I worked for a very good bank, so we were the least guilty out of all of them. We didn't even take TARP funds, but as a bank, you start, you know, just seeing, like, God, some of the stuff we let people do with their money and how we let them do it is what got them into this problem. And now we're like, whoop, can't pay for it, we're taking it away, and it was miserable. So I've had those type of jobs. I've worked in security, done all these different things, and yeah, this is not very stressful, but I work way harder on this than any job that I've ever had. It requires about four times the amount of hours. As far as social life, you might as well just get used to not having one. It doesn't work. It doesn't, you don't go out, you can't, there's no time. You have to be dedicated 100% of your life in with a family, three kids, a wife and three kids. It's a huge sacrifice to be able to have to spend. And I know some people that work outside of this, I don't understand that. They're like, you know, and another thing too is, this type of thing, playing games, is something that many people enjoy to do in their off time or their hobby. But when you turn it into work, where you make your employment, I'm not. And again, I'm not saying I don't enjoy it. I'm very happy with what I get to do. But it, I'm telling you, it'll change it. It'll make it where some people I can easily see actually, you know, not even enjoying it anymore. They do enough of it. I've not had that problem. I've had a lot of jobs in the past. Like when I before I went to the bank, when I was a young guy, I was, you know, cell phones were out. I got really into cell phones. I thought they were the coolest thing in the late 90s. Everybody was starting to get them, and I was just obsessed with them. I thought they were the coolest, neatest little devices. We're throwing our pagers in the trash can and getting... So I went to work for T-Mobile. And I was there at a really good time because nobody else hardly had cell phones. Most people did not have a cell phone. So it was a very new thing. And I was selling cell phones and teaching people how to use a cell phone and what it was all about. And there was a lot of money to be made at that time. And within a three-year period that I was there, I went from working with people that only worked 3 weeks and they took a week and they'd go vacation somewhere like Europe and elsewhere because they were making so much. And I did not get in on that, unfortunately. I was too late to the party. I got started and I was able to pay my bills and I had money and I didn't know what to do with it, but I still couldn't afford nice things. I was a 21-year-old kid, had more money than I could spend. At the, you know, of course, I could have went and spent it, but I you know, I had my apartment paid, I had my car paid. I went on a few little vacations. You know, I'd go out drinking with my friends at the bar, and the money was going up in the account, and even though I was spending, it was still climbing. I didn't go out and, like, go on lavish vacations, but I just did some fun things. And by the time I got done, I was making probably minimum wage 3 years later because the market got so saturated. And it was terrible. It was like, I went from working with adults that were, like, you know, making very, very good money to, at the end, 3 years later, I was working with high school kids that were looking for a part-time job. It was bad. It was so bad. Because everybody had cell phones. It was a saturated market. So, I mean, I got burned out. I hate cell phones to this day. People start talking about cell phones, and I just go like, oh, stop. I hate cell phones. I don't even want one. I hate cell phones. There's nothing about cell phones that I find cool at all. They're stupid little stupid things that you carry around, and they just suck. They try to be a computer, but they're not. Just... And so, thank you so much to D0Cal and Burr72 for the big follows. And then another job I had years later was it was right after the cell phones. I was really getting into motorcycling. And I started a little collection. We had three bikes at one point, and I went to work selling motorsports products. Started out at a place up in White Bear Lake, Minnesota called Towsley Motorsports. And absolutely loved it. Started there in May, motorcycling. I was just gangbusters. All I could think about was motorcycles. So I went to sell them. And I loved them so much that in October, when they started putting motorcycles away and dragging out those wretched snowmobiles, not a fan. I love the snowmobiles are fine. I just dealing with them is not fun. I said, you know what? I don't want to stop selling them. And if they're gonna put them away for the winter and nobody wants to buy them up here because it's 30 below zero, I'm gonna move south. And so packed it up, January, and moved to Tennessee. And right back on, I bought a new motorcycle in December. Brand new one, nice touring bike. And loaded it up on a trailer. It was snowing, it was my 24th birthday. And it was snowing out when I brought it home. Put it on a trailer, it sat there for 2 weeks. 2 weeks later, I took it to Tennessee. Unloaded it down in Tennessee, down in Nashville. And I jumped on it and rode it for the first time. Rode that bike for the first time. And so I got so gangbusters over motorcycles a year or two down the road, I burnt myself out big time on bikes. Couldn't stand them. Saw a friend and a coworker that worked at the bike shop. He died. He had a bike just like me. He crashed it and died on it. He died. I wasn't with him, but I saw a bunch of my customers that would go out the door one day. They'd come back a week later in a body cast. Saw a couple people crash in the parking lot, and I just started having, like, visions of what was going to happen to me on a motorcycle one day, and I just didn't want to deal with it, and I got burned out, and I left. That's your GunninGamerz story time for the day, but people ask me about doing game stuff all the time. You gotta know what kind of person you are. I've got enough experience now with doing hobbies as jobs that I know how not to get burned out, so I won't let myself. That's kind of why we're taking a week off next week. It's time to do something else for a week. and I still got to work on videos, but not gonna be doing live streams next week. And it's very important because I know one person that started YouTube with me, and he got so burned out he doesn't even have a YouTube account anymore. He closed it. He threw all his crap away. He packed up his bags and walked away. He can't stand YouTube. He doesn't want to look at it. He hates Twitch. So I mean, it can burn you really bad, really really burn you out, and you gotta know your limits. But I always tell people, hey, if you think this is easy, do it. Get you a YouTube. It's your YouTube, buy editing software, spend all the money, tap out your account, start up a Twitch channel, grab some games, and go to town and see what you make of it. You know, but just get ready to work for pennies for a while, because that's all you're going to get, you know. You'll be getting pennies. It took me about a month to make $1 on YouTube when I got going. I think it was about a month. I took a picture of it, my first dollar. I was like, sweet! But yeah, I always encourage people, you know, never want to discourage them from trying it. Just, you know, the people that say, oh, it's easier, it's playing games, try it. Just try it and see. I guarantee you after about a few months, you'll probably, if you have any hair left on your head, you'll probably say, yeah, I think I'd rather just, you're going to do one of two things. You're either going to say, yeah, I'd rather just go ahead and get a different job, or, you know what, I'm going to keep fighting and I'm going to keep grinding, and I'm going to sit here and work through and make something happen. And I was at the point with my computer repair business, I didn't want to go back to that anymore. And I didn't really want to go work for somebody else. That was my biggest problem. After being self-employed, having my own business, I really, really knew that I was best off to always have control over my own destiny. I'm not one of those people that plays well with others when it comes to working for corporations. I didn't mind working for a small company that was, you know, like family-owned. Because you could literally go up to the top guy and say, hey, why are we doing this like this? But I'll tell you what. It's a challenge. But yeah, as Jason was saying, I'm using Logitech Driving Force. It's an outdated steering wheel that's no longer made. I only use it for farming. I don't use it for any other games. I use a G27. Excuse me. And yeah, we definitely do not ever use money cheats. Ever, ever, ever. It's the quickest way to ruin your game if you're looking to ruin your game. And that's just my opinion. Some people aren't big fans of the game. They just want to get in and try out all the stuff and then go play something else. We're big fans of the game. And so if you're a big fan of the game or you think you're going to like the game, do yourself a huge favor and do the grind. Play in hard mode. Play with crops on slow. Put it on a server if you really want a challenge, and let the plant crops wait 48 hours of real lifetime before they're done, and then you got 24 hours to get them off, or they wither, and you lose it all. And you'll really start to appreciate this game a lot better. It's the best way, in my opinion, to do it. And I've been playing the farming for a lot of years now, and this is the first time that we've ran everything in a dedicated server. And it's definitely the way that I'll be doing it in the future, because it offers the ultimate challenge, at least that you can get right now. This is a lovely little tractor here, as far as it's just the visibility. I've always liked it. I liked it in 2013. Got such great visibility. You almost feel like you're not even in a cab. That'd be kind of nice, too, if they threw in some real big, like a real big farm all, the older, you know, without the cabs on them. You know, like a 1486 or something, you know, without a cab. Just, that thing, that would be so slick. Hopefully somebody will mod one of those in one day. Yeah, we don't use Skype, we always use TeamSpeak. Skype is, like, good for talking with your family and stuff, but it's not good for gamers and stuff. I mean, it can work. I don't really understand why people use it. TeamSpeak is the go-to choice. Skype is not made for gaming. TeamSpeak is. It has a way to set up a lot of different things. It's a program made for gamers and communicating in games. Whereas Skype is like, you know, get on there with your grandma and show her your art project that you made in school today. you know, it's good for talking with family. We try to use it. Oh my goodness, we're full. This tractor is getting owned, but it is listed. Horsepower-wise, it is listed. It's like on the smallest side, I think. For this forage wagon. And it definitely works it. But that's okay, because we're not going too far. Oh my goodness. The wagon is fishtailing on me there. Yeah, we're getting a little glitch with this. We're doing basically everything that one can do to break the game here. I gotta pull a little bit farther forward. One thing I'm gonna do. Put that at about probably 3 miles an hour. We're gonna use cruise control to get a nice smooth pile. Let's just go ahead and fill this one. Thinking about it here, that's just gonna be farther. We have to roll back and forth, so let's head back to this pit. I like to use cruise control when I unload. Then you get a nice smooth pile. I haven't figured out the right speed yet, though, to do that. So we're gonna turn on our cruise control, 3 miles an hour. Yeah, that's too fast. Too fast. So probably 2 miles an hour would... 2 miles an hour seem a little bit slow, but... We're gonna go 3 again, because we only got a half a trailer. And these... Every implement's gonna be different, as well as... The pit. The pit, if it was regular size, would have been fine at 3. I'm not really a big fan of these short pits. I wish they would have rather put in 4 of the regular size ones, but not a real big deal, I guess. Just probably comes in handy. Alright. We got a nice even pile. We don't get a big old lump. Let's head back out and pick up some more. Yes, this definitely goes on YouTube. Definitely does go on the YouTube. Once you update Farm Sim, where do you put it? Hey, how's it going there, Fast? And Kong? What's happening? We got a little bit of silage here. Or, grass here, rather. Oops. Forgot once that goes full, it pulls the, head up there. Oh, this little glitchiness with the vehicles drives me crazy. All vanilla equipment, too. Jesus! Holy crapper! Oh my god! That's gonna be so loud. Oh my goodness, holy crapper, tractor T18 for $38. My goodness, thank you for the classy, generous donation. Holy shice, my heart just came to us. Wow. Oh my god, why is that so loud? Somebody turn it up? I did not turn that up. That almost broke my headset. Oh man, that was just, that one caught me. Some of them just get me more than others. That one freaking got me. Jesus. Oh, crepes. Setting off the C4, very classy. Oh, I thought the silage plant exploded. I thought we had some fermenting that went wrong with the heat and it just freaking blew. Somebody put fertilizer in there and some diesel fuel and just let it go. Somebody dumped the diesel fuel into the fertilizer. Jesus. Went all frickin' Ted Kaczynski on the damn thing. Oh my goodness. Thank you to Zeppity, the King 432 Farmer, Burr 72. Did I forget somebody here? We better double check. Oh, Bird 72 and D.O.Cal, thank you so much for those follows. Why no music is because this is going on YouTube. And if you have music, Twitch will mute the entire VOD. And even if they didn't, once it gets to YouTube, you'll get copyright stuff on it. So, can't put copywritten music on there, so we don't play any music during farm update. This is an effort to show off our other servers. Have something different to look at, as well as to spend some time on the servers, the other servers, and to get more content onto YouTube. Because one thing, all of the fine people there on the YouTube, GunninGamerz YouTube, are always asking is, we want to see more farming, and it's really hard to set aside the time to put more farming videos out. And so I thought, what the heck? We have two other servers, we might as well do something with them. Which is what I intended on doing all along, it just took till March to get that done. Tractor, thank you again. Holy cow, your ears are bleeding. What did you say? I can't hear you. I know, that was crazy! Oh man. that one really rung the ears pretty good. Some of them are just, you know, just big, and that was a biggie. Yeah, Westbridge will be up next in just about 50 minutes. And Westbridge is, stick around, Westbridge is going to be good. We're going to be seeing some good stuff on Westbridge. You're going to want to stick around, we're going to have synchronized farming again. It'll be a good time. A good time had by all. Just rolling away here. Love the first person on this thing though. Man. I'm gonna shut the inspector off. Figure we'll just roll like this. Not gonna let you. I mean, you'll know when you come to a close on it, because it'll... Yep, Westbridge, we've got a bunch of crops, and holy cow, you've got to see some of the stuff we've done with the greenhouses. Oh, man. Westbridge has got some nice things we're going to be looking at. Nope, it'll just be farming right now today. This is a farm update Friday. Getting a little farm update Friday. One of the other important things too, why I'm doing these during the middle of the afternoon, on a day we normally don't live stream, is to help those that are in different countries over across the pond in Europe. Because a lot of our European fans say, I wish I could watch you live stream, but you know, You don't start till 1 o'clock in the morning, to 2 o'clock in the morning my time. 1 o'clock in the morning on Wednesdays and Sundays, and Saturday it's, well, technically it's Sunday, Monday, but you get my drift. It's late. I start normally at 7 o'clock my time, 7 p.m. my time on Wednesdays and Sundays, and 8 o'clock on Saturday. So, you know, it doesn't work out for a lot of our European fans. A lot of them will try to pop in towards the end of my streams because it's like the morning. They're like waking up 7, 8 o'clock in the morning. I'm still on because I usually run 6-hour live streams. And, you know, they'll pop in right about the time I'm getting done. And they'll try to catch a little bit. So I thought, hey, we're going to do this on Friday, that Friday night, you know. Right now it's in the evening hours in Euroland. Oh, and Asia. Ah, that's true too. I don't know. Never have too many people say from Asia that that they pop in, but maybe DJ, you're over there in Israel, so, or some say here Israel. but yeah. It's a good time over there, so thank you to Z Petty, and we've got Chris Kidd, and of course we had the King 43 Bergnasty. Thank you so much for those follows. Normally during our live stream, especially the farming, we do crank on the country music. That is a big part of the farm. But these Friday farm updates, again, we can't because of the copyrights and things like that. This is going to go on YouTube. I don't think people would enjoy watching a 2-hour-long video with no sound. I think that would probably not get viewed very much. So, and also, most of the time, today's a little quiet, but most of the time we'll be doing multiplayer. There'll be other people in the server with me here. So we'll be talking and... Sometimes the music can get a little bit much, but I believe Jason and Lee are going to hop into Westbridge when we're in there, because we're going to have synchronized farming going on. We got a lot of fields that need to be busted out. Maybe we'll get one more in there. We got 3 combines. It'd be real nice to get all 3 of those combines going with the synchronized farming. Be a real good time. OCD is saying, pick that grass up. I hate grass on the roads too. This drives me crazy. It's like, damn it, we gotta pick that up. Alright, we'll pick up this little shot here, and then we'll color good enough. Now, question is, do they want me to compact this? Jason, if you're still listening, do you want me to compact this and cover it, or leave it open for the next bunch of fun. It's not going to be very full. We've got 8 pits, so I don't know if it was me, I think I'd probably just go ahead and get her started. When you got so many empty pits, that's kind of how we do it in our other maps. We don't wait to fill the pit. We're never going to have enough to fill all the pits. Nice even pile there. Pretty much anyway. Okay. All empty. Go ahead and cover it. Oh, ASAM. Jump on in there. We'll need some synchronous farming big time. It's gonna be a lot of fun, man. That is some of the most fun I've had in Farming Simulator in a while. And doing something as simple as getting all of our combines synchronized and hammering out some fields like the olden days in Westbridge 2013 server. Oh man, did we have fun. Those were some good times. Look at that, just standing that thing right up. I don't know if I should, I don't know what's heavier. What do you think is heavier? We could weigh. I can't remember. 6,000? 9,000? I can't remember what the front loader was. Oh, we'll check it out. Let's see how much do we weigh here. What's our weight coming in at? Oh, definitely going to be a lot heavier than the front loader. Plus, the front loader's really slow right now. Is someone helping TeamSpeak? Have you fallen and you can't get up? Is the first day of spring tomorrow or Sunday? It's actually today! Happy first day of spring, everybody. Unlike last Friday, I don't have my windows open. It's a little bit chilly out there today and a little bit cloudy. There's an ad playing, yet I can hear the stream. Holy crapper, thank you for watching those ads. They support the stream. I know that ads are not fun. I've had people say, oh, I don't worry about ads, I just use ad blocker, and that is like, hey, why don't you just go ahead and spit in my face while you're at it? More than anything, you know, especially with YouTube wouldn't happen if it wasn't for those ads. I always watch the ads. I skip them a lot of times. But I watch actually a good bit of the ads because I know how much that supports the people that I like to watch on YouTube. And my wife is going to be doing some work on the GunninGamerz YouTube channel. We're going to be taking a look at some different ads, and we're going to get ads that are more tailored towards our crowd to see if we can make some changes in our revenue. And so, just kind of an example of that is if you're watching a hunting video, we'll try to have ads that pertain to hunting stuff, hunting channels, maybe Cabela's, Gander Mountain, Bass Pro Shop, something like that. You might catch a little ad or a video. We had 100? Are we at 100? I was looking at the other deal. You know, when you watch farming, you might have a Case IH or a John Deere commercial. Stuff that people are more likely to watch than to hit to skip, but you gotta really remember how important those ads are for Twitch and YouTube. And when you use ad blocker, you are not contributing at all to supporting those sites and those people that work very hard at creating that content on there. So people always say, oh, I wish I could subscribe, I really wish I could subscribe or donate or something. All we ask is, you know what? Hey, just by you being here, when you watch those ads, when you set through those ads, that is more than, you know, than anything right there. Especially on YouTube, because YouTube, you can't pay for subscriptions. Well, you can actually, but it's a big no-no when you're doing game stuff. The game companies will nail your ass to the wall. That's what it says in a lot of the contracts, is that I think every contract I have for the games I play, except for the Hunter, they told me, they didn't say anything that I couldn't do that, but I would not do that anyway. Most games that you play, if you have above 10,000 subscribers, you can make it where it costs money to watch your YouTube channel. I've never seen anybody do that. I think it'd kill your channel if you did. And I can tell you one thing, it wouldn't be worth it. And I've never seen any channel cost money on YouTube, but it is possible. It's $10 a month, I think is what it is. If I remember right. $10 a month. And so, it's, but most of the games say if you do that, you can't put their content on. Alright, now we're at 100. 51 down here in St. Louis. It is not that warm here. Oh, cover it up. Compacting 100%. It's only 24%, but you know, when you got 8 pits, it's like, just do it. That's how we'd run it on Bjornholm. As soon as we're done doing, because we're going to have that thing emptied out and be using it and have the silo empty by the time we have more grass or corn or something to put in. Once you get your farms really, really up and going big, that's when you need to... That's when you need to do things a little bit different. That's when you need to make sure that your silos are full, because you're going to have silos full all the time with more crop waiting to go in. And in R13, that would frustrate me. That would frustrate me when people would go and cover the pit with like half full, and it's like, we needed that pit! We got crops that need to go in. Our trailers are full! All of our trailers are full of crops we can't dump anywhere, and now our silage pit's tied up till tomorrow. Dang it! You got withering on and plant growth and a dedicated server. You gotta plan for stuff like that. Thank you so much to Hager125, Let Trucker, and Y84 Media. Thank you so much. Could care less about the ads in Twitch. Well, that's what keeps Twitch going. You gotta care about that kind of stuff. You don't want to be an asshat and not support the things that you enjoy doing, like watching Twitch and YouTube. A lot of people think that these things are just created by, you know, good times and fun. You know, Twitch in particular, you know, partners. And I'll tell you right now, you don't get paid much off those ads. We're talking about fractions of a cent. It ain't much. You don't make much, but Twitch in general makes money off those ads. That money is what it takes to keep Twitch rolling. They have got to have that. Right now, Twitch could be doing better and expanding more if they had more money to do it. No, they were just bought 6 months ago by Amazon for $1 billion, which has helped a lot, but it takes a lot of money to keep this stuff going. So when you are ad blocking, you're basically cheating the system, and I don't understand the whole concept, the mindset behind that, because it's just a few seconds of an ad. It's not that big of a deal. Get turbo, and you don't have to worry about the ads. If you don't have the money for turbo, then you're probably somebody that should be contributing, at least by letting the ad play on your PC or your whatever device you're using. It really is important to do that, to support that. Without those ads, just like the commercials on TV, there wouldn't be any TV, or everything would be paid for. People get so pissed off at cable. I don't want to pay for cable. I don't want to. But you complain about the, you know, commercials on the TV. You can't have both. People gotta eat. You know, it's common sense here, folks. It's not rocket science we're talking about. How much does PewDiePie make off those ads? PewDiePie is so different because he's actually been purchased by Disney. PewDiePie is probably... I don't know. You could probably find the information somewhere, but I guarantee... How much is Disney making off of PewDiePie? Millions. Otherwise, Disney wouldn't have bought his ass. So, I don't know all the specifics on that, but how much is PewDiePie made off of his YouTube? He's, you know, I don't know. How do you even begin? He's made over $1 million, let's just say that. But then again, I think he's, what, part of Maker's owned by Disney? I could be wrong on that, but he's had so many hands in the pot. PewDiePie is the only one you'll see in his videos. I haven't watched him. Maybe he's got other people, but it's been a long, long time. But, you know, he's the number one guy on YouTube, so, you kind of just got to guess. But for the longest time, he's had people that help him with his videos, content, you know, probably do a lot of his editing. I don't know. I'm just assuming here. A guy of that size, I can't imagine he sits there and does all that himself. I don't know why he would. Making that kind of money, you might as well have a bunch... Might as well sit down and just play the game, hand the video, raw video off to somebody, let them do some fancy editing and upload it, and you're on to the next thing. You know, you gotta be a machine. It's something I wish I had. Maybe I'll have to get Aiden taught on how to do editing. He can do all the editing, and or get my boys, one day I'd like to, they can help with editing so we can spit more content out. You know, make a video, we got it. You know, a bunch of people working on editing it, get it out, upload it onto YouTube, on to the next thing. It's not the playing the games, and that's what people don't understand. It's like, I think playing games on YouTube is an easy thing. Playing the games is only like this little tiny piece of what you're actually doing. When you go to edit the videos and all the stuff that's entailed, that's where the hard stuff, if you're doing it right, if you're just cobbling your videos into a Windows Movie Maker and just, you know, farting them out 5 minutes later and shoving it on YouTube like that, well, you know, your channel probably won't go anywhere. I mean, it might, I guess, you know. Some people have made it happen, but for most people, you've got to really put time into editing. So if you're playing a game for an hour, you're looking at many hours of editing. So it's kind of like having a job. People say, oh, you play games, it's a living. No, I edit videos for a living. Playing the game is like my drive to work. Some people drive to work for their job, and they turn on the music, and they're jam out, got their sunroof open, I'm going to work, so excited, you know, whatever they're doing, and they have a 30-minute commute to work and a 30-minute home. They spend an hour in a car every day. A YouTuber, it's the same thing. You spend an hour jamming out, playing the game, yay, I love the game, and then the work comes when it's time to edit. Okay, that's when your job begins. Playing the game is not the job. Playing the game is the enjoyment, the fun drive on the way to work when you got your, let your hair down, let your sunroof open. He isn't allowed to curse in, huh? Teach Aiden how to edit videos in a few months. We'll do that. It'd be awesome. Child labor. When is this going on YouTube? Probably by tomorrow. Probably not tonight, because I want to do the crew. Look at this fuel barrel. It looped three of these together. Oh my god, I got run over by my equipment. Why is that tractor still running? So, this is how much fuel they actually have. 2.879. Wow. That's how much fuel, and they loop three of these tanks together to make it look a little bit more nice, I guess? It wouldn't have had to do that, but it just looks nice. I like that they did that. I was like, oh, that's cool. So yeah, you gotta make your own fuel. We should probably go over and check that stuff out. Kinda don't know what else we should do now. There's always stuff to do, but see, we've been going for almost an hour and a half. We could probably, we'll go and have a little look around the map. Parks our equipment in the shed. Hello, Vilsoni. It shows that you spend a lot of time editing your videos. Oh, thank you, Barley Hopswater. I wish I was a better editor. I am not I am a basic editor. It is not something that's come easy for me, because I'm really picky about it too, and I've chose to go with very simple but nice looking editing. You know, it's simple, but it gets the job done, and it's not boogery, and that's the best I can do. I have not had the time or the resources to learn how to really make nice movies with all kinds of effects, and you can all overdo your videos too. I've seen some really very successful YouTubers that have even more basic editing than myself, and it works. It's their channel. It does the trick. It gets the job done. It's clean. It's simple. And that's kind of the approach that I've gone into. But yeah, it takes me a lot of time to edit videos. I'm really picky about, and I'm not a good, I don't consider myself a good YouTuber, a video maker. I consider myself a thorough editor. Because I have to edit out a lot of crap that I do that I don't like, that I do things wrong, say things, don't. sounds, you know, picky about everything being, and so my editing process is like just it's a very hard because I'm very picky, and I think there's some people that are just naturals at making videos, and I've never considered myself one of those people. I think that every time I personally feel like I make a video, I feel like I just made a train wreck, and I'm like, what is this? Oh my god, I gotta edit this all out! And it's also very difficult. Oh my god, you wanna throw a monkey wrench in there? Throw a 4-year-old or a 3-year-old or a 5-year-old in your video. That's a good idea. Holy crap, you guys have no idea. Well, you see it on the live stream. You see it on the live stream. He's, wow. I should put some of the bloopers in. But, oh, it takes a bunch. Okay. Oh, did it actually take the whole thing? Burnier. Sweet. Baron Y84 and Bud Monster. I thought it was going to say Bud Light. Oh, I don't like Bud Light. Budweiser. I don't know why, but beer sounds good, and it's not even 5 o'clock yet. So, alright, we got that thing full of 20,000. Let's go have a little, see what truck is on the white farm. I don't know, this thing here. Somebody's got to get that figured out. What's going on? That thing is not running. Oh my god, the corn. Yeah. I'm afraid this'll, do we actually drive this and go dump? I don't think we should do that during the video. That is a very boring thing. I took the crops out, now somebody's gotta go empty it. We might have to do a server restart later and see if we can get this to work a little better. 5 miles an hour is, top speed is, and it's not the bin either. See, we just got rid of the trigger. Same result. It actually goes faster in reverse. I'm going 10 miles an hour in reverse. Alright, we will drive backwards. Hopefully they get something figured out with the map. I don't know if they... Maybe it's not a problem. I don't know what's... I don't know. Something's a problem, though. We've been having a lot of problems with that. We're going twice the speed in reverse. Oh, thank you, Bloopa Radio. Thank you so much. Yes, Sparky, that unfortunately happens. Oh, Roadmaster's here. Don't worry, now he's here. I'm glad you didn't come in a few minutes ago. We were just talking all kind of bad stuff about you. You're saying that guy just monkeyed up our whole server. Many great minds thinking alike. It's 5 o'clock somewhere. Oh, wow. I know, I'm having like a Homer Simpson moment. We're just going to park this over here. I think we've done enough driving in reverse for today. How far do we have to go? That's a long way. Is it? Is that a long way? Where are we? Oh, we're down that way. Oh, we should have went the other way. Holy buckets. Yeah. Well, we gotta dump it over here. I don't know where they want this. I'll leave it in the middle of the yard for them. Right here's the silo-y thingy up here somewhere. Somewhere up around this corner, you can dump it here and let them... Oh my goodness. Faster in reverse. I just don't understand, like, what... See all the different triggers. I don't know, something is just farting up on this, so... I'm not even sure where the silo is on this farm. There's your seed and your fertilizer. Maybe you gotta dump it in one of these deals, but we're gonna leave that. No. That looks like some manure. We'll let somebody come and decide where they want to put that. Maybe they're gonna bring it down and dump it in for fuel. I'll just leave it there. We gotta find a truck. I don't know what happened to all the trucks. Every farm had a truck. I've never explored. We're gonna see if the trucks even work right now, because we're having other vehicle issue. See how fast we'll get the truck. Oh, trucks seem to be going a little faster anyway. No, we're not gonna get across the map at 27 miles an hour. No, this is, it's not good. Alright, we'll put this away. There's the Chevrolet. You guys are always asking about it. This is the White Farm, which is basically Bjornholm. Kind of the way the buildings are laid out on Bjornholm. Yeah, that kind of looks like Bjornholm a little bit. And there's a house up there. Farm store is right down there. Oh my goodness. Alright. Close our garage door. That'd be Aiden's job if he was in here. Very slick. Very slick. And close that one too. Exit stage left. Keep the burglars out. And they got some fuel over here too. So I think that'll probably be it on our Pleasant Valley for today. It'll be 2 weeks before we do update number 3. Because like I said, I don't think we're going to do one next Friday. That'll really give this server especially some time to mature. To get some more money in. And if you're curious on how this map works, the seed, the fertilizer, I did a bunch of that stuff in update number 1, which is on my YouTube. From last week, it's 2 hours. I highly encourage you to jump over and check that out, because you will find kind of explaining all the different crops like corn, barley, canola, wheat, millet, cotton, sorghum, which is, you know, used for fuel, sunflower, hemp, and sugar beet, potato and sugar cane. And then you've got other things here like the wood chips, manure, silage, mixer, ash and straw, grass and chaff. So there's lots of different things to do on this map. It's very, very in-depth. It's why we're running it. This is the 1.2 version, by the way. And it just came out a few days ago. Last week, actually. Last Friday. Thursday night, Friday. We got it in right away. So they're still working on the map, I think. And there's a few little bugs and kinks that I think they're working out. But it's pretty good. It's the most in-depth you're going to get on Farming 15. And hopefully this one will get us by at least a year. We'll be running this map for about a year, so just imagine. We'll probably get up to, like, update somewhere in the 50s. And that'll help get some more content for Farming Simulator. And again, this one we were doing more general farming. We didn't really get into doing seed and fertilizer stuff, but you'll see that more in the future. It's in update 1 from last week. And in the future, you'll see us when we're building the buildings, buying factories and doing all that sort of thing. We'll be getting into the mining. There is a, turn the HUD on. There is a mine. Well, you look on the top left, all kinds of business up there. You got, right on Lakeview. One's a mine, a quarry. I don't know. There's just a bunch of different things. There's stuff all over the map. But you can check out their Facebook page. It'll be in the link on this when it gets to YouTube. It also is already in the description on update 1. If you want to get hooked up with this map, it works really nice single player. Go to their Facebook, go to our YouTube, check the link, go to their Facebook, and you can get set up on it. There's a racetrack, there's a little go-kart or something that they had. I guess they're working on that. So it's really cool looking racetrack. Airport up there. I've never been up to that. This is a bunch of different things, and it's a 4x map, so it's basically 4 West Bridges or 4 Bjornholms glued together. We're going to go ahead and jump out of there for the day. It'll be a little bit shorter than 2 hours, and that's okay.